Today we are going to discuss the Azygos system of vein. The Azygos vein. First make the rough diagram of vertebrae. So we have to draw T1 to T12 vertebrae. Because this Azygos system mainly you will see in the upper part of the lumbar region and the thoracic region. So these are the vertebra. This is the superior vena cava, and right and left brachiocephalic vein. This is left brachiocephalic vein, right brachiocephalic vein. Below we have the inferior vena cava. At the T12 you will see the 12th rib. This one vein is ascending from the common iliac vein in the lumbar region and it receiving the lumbar vein. So upper four lumbar vein it is receiving. So these are the lumbar veins, and this ascending branch is known as the ascending lumbar vein. It will ascend in front of the vertebras, and also it will receive the subcostal vein. So 12th vein is known as the subcostal vein. So these will join to form the Azygos vein, and sometimes also you will see the lumbar Azygos vein. These will join to form the Azygos vein. Azygos vein then ascending on the mainly on the right side of the vertebra, in front of the vertebra, and at the level of T4 it will arch and drain into the superior vena cava. This is the Azygos vein, and it will receive the posterior intercostal veins, the T5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So these are the posterior intercostal veins. Second, third and fourth join to form the superior intercostal vein and draining into the arch of the Azygos vein. First will directly drain into the right brachiocephalic vein. Similarly, on the left side we have ascending lumbar vein receiving the lumbar veins, subcostal vein joining with the ascending lumbar vein to form the hemiazygous vein. They will receive the T9, 10, 11 posterior intercostal veins. So this is the hemiazygous vein. So at the level of lower border of T8, it will join with the azygous vein. Above side we have the accessory hemiazygous vein. It will receive the 5, 6, 7 and 8 posterior intercostal veins. So this is the accessory hemiazygous vein draining into the Azygos vein. Similarly, on the left side we have the second, third and fourth vein joined to form the superior intercostal vein draining into the left brachiocephalic vein. First will directly drain into the left brachiocephalic vein. So this is the schematic diagram, superior vena cava, this is the inferior vena cava, then the ascending lumbar vein joining with the, these are the four lumbar veins, and right subcostal vein joined to form the Azygos vein. So at the level of T4 it will arch along the right hilum and draining into the superior vena cava. Then second, third and fourth joint to form the superior intercostal vein. These are the posterior intercostal veins, 5 to 11 directly draining into the Azygos vein. First will drain into the right brachiocephalic vein. Then we have the hemiazygous vein. These are the lumbar veins ascending lumbar vein, left subcostal vein, then it will receive the 9, 10 and 11, and at the level of T8 vertebra it will join with the azygos vein. Above side we have the accessory azygos vein. It will receive the 5, 6, 7 and 8 posterior intercostal vein and draining into the azygos vein. Then 2nd, 3rd and 4th join to form the superior intercostal veins. Thanks for watching.